And Mr. Sabo, I really like your speech. I think it was very encouraging. I think it was very enlightening. And I like also the fact you talked about being creative. And I think that, you know, the North Corporation is actually based on creativity, but also based on a very long tradition of cooperation. Talk about sharing energy. That we do that already in the world, and they are more than willing to share with you. As you know, this is the commercial. Norway has a lot of gas. We talk about the hot springs. We have the cold springs. So, together with the Finnish sauna, first. Okay, now, this is Abo. This is Makari. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to thank our Hungarian colleagues for this very timely initiative, and also thank all of you for actually participating in this meeting today. Because today's program focuses on green transport, focuses on smart cities, green heating, sustainable buildings and constructions, and in addition to this, we also focus on the financing of the sustainable projects. And these are actually topics that are very close to my heart. I think that they are extremely important and they will become even more important in the future. So sustainable development and making the transition to a low carbon and a green economy is a challenge for all of us. And if we are to succeed, we will need to cooperate more and we will need to learn from each other. And this gives us opportunities for interaction and economic growth that you should embrace. In 2017, like Mr. Sabo said, Norway has the presidency of the Nordic Council of Ministers. This council was formally established in 1971, but it has actually considerably deeper roots. I would say that this cooperation actually started after the Second World War. And luckily, you know, this Nordic integration and the cooperation that we have has been a success story from the start. So together, we are influencing our present and the future by launching common political initiatives. And we are also taking practical steps across all sectors of society. Now, the Nordic economies, they are undergoing rapid transformation, and this actually calls for a higher pace of innovation and entrepreneurship than it used to be. So the region is today regarded as the most integrated region in Europe, and we would actually like to further strengthen this image that we have on being so integrated. So Nordic cooperation is about making life better, more being more productive, and also more rewarding for our citizens and for our communities and also for our businesses. So that is said, we are fully aware that we cannot achieve this in isolation from the rest of the world. Now, the transition to a green economy is a key priority for Nordic cooperation. And we have a special initiative on this, and we call it the Nordic Green Growth Initiative. This was launched in 2015. And this has a vision based on the pooling of the Nordic countries' strength in a number of areas. For example, in testing out new energy solutions, in promoting flexible energy consumption, in education, and also in training and research of green growth, and in promoting new norms and new standards. So this Green Growth Initiative, it actually aims to promote greener procurement in the public sector. It aims to development of new methods of waste treatment, a circular economy, the integration of environmental and climate consideration into development aid, and increased funding for green investment and green companies. You all hear that this is a very ambitious agenda. But furthermore, a central pillar to the program for the Norway's presidency of the Nordic Council of Ministers is the enhanced cooperation with our neighbors in Europe on reaching these goals. And now I talk about, you know, the Norwegian presidency. But what is important here is that the Finns, Finland have the presidency before us, we have it now, and then Sweden takes over next year. And maybe that doesn't end, you know, when the Norwegian, one of the presidencies ends. Because, I mean, we try to keep this in sort of a constant process. Okay, so coming back to Hungary, we see Hungary as a highly competent and interested and very positioned partner. The EU framework offers excellent opportunities for success, but it is also important to pay attention to the macro regional level. For example, in the cooperation across the Nordic, the Baltic, and also the Visegrad regions. And we are looking forward to the start of the new presidency of the Visegrad in July. That you know, all of our countries have strong bilateral links with Hungary in areas such as business relations, in investments, research, culture, and people-to-people contacts. And today's program will showcase examples of this and how we can forward to build an even more sustainable region. And Norway, Iceland, and Hungary have a particularly important forum for cooperation in the EEA and the Nordic grants. In the current period of these grants, which is now coming to an end, actually around 40 million euros was allocated to projects in the areas of the green or energy efficiency, renewable energy, climate change and adaptation, and also green innovation. So the green industry innovation program and its 37 individual projects. And when we have this cooperation in about an hour, if you rest now, have a look at the display in the outside in the hallway, because it shows the project and of course this has relevance for the today's conference. So this means that we are actually already delivering cooperation under this program. And in general, we see that the projects under the EEA and the Nordic grants have yielded very good results, not only in practical terms, but also as platforms for professional exchange, which is important, you know that, for getting new ideas abroad, and also not to forget creating new business contacts. And they have also helped to prepare grants and even larger and stronger program in the next funding period. So we need to continue. And clearly, the projects are considered most successful. The projects that are considered most successful also have an active foreign partner. And this is an approach we want to develop further, and as we discussed in the meeting we have before the conference started. And we will strive to ensure that every major project is given a capable EEA partner. That could be a public agency, it could be an educational or a research institution, or it can be a company. And in this way, we ensure that we will benefit from Hungarian expertise and also experience. When I talk to Norwegian companies or partners that are involved in the EEA, the Norwegian grant projects, I get the information from them that the transfer of know-how is goes both ways. And we that is a very important figure. So success, as you know, comes from hard work, from making use of existing opportunities and developing new ideas, and also making new friends. And it is vital to have proper framework conditions and financing in place to get going with started and getting the project. So governments and public institutions have a key role today. And collectively, the countries of Europe have excellent instruments at their disposal. including major mobility programs in education and research. We have the Horizon 2020, which is important, not even for a non-EU member as us. And then as a non-EU member, Norway actually subscribes to and we support and we and you also implement these and other key elements in on the European sustainable agenda. So we are partners and we are seeking to achieve the same goals. And we have already succeeded, luckily, in many areas. We have grounds for optimism together, and Norway is therefore opposed to any attempt to devalue the effects of cooperation or diminish the achievements of Europe over the last generation. And the levels of well-being, security and freedom now enjoyed by 510 million citizens of the European Economic Area are unprecedented. And we are against all attempts to turn back the clock and limit the space for interaction and exchange of ideas and knowledge. So ultimately, the success is depending on economic actors and their ability to turn ideas, opportunities, and technology into the profitable provision of goods and services. And of course, we are here today, but we cannot be sure of what this present problem will result in, or whether new businesses will be able to start up and prosper. But we can be sure of one thing. Contact will continue. Ideas will be exchanged. And I am sure that working together, Hungary and the Nordic region will actually become stronger and more competitive than it is.